Back here on a Monday morning, first things first, with Chris Broussard talking some Lakers Suns game one yesterday. And Broussard, it was Phoenix who landed the first punch. It was Phoenix who came out strong. It was Phoenix who looked every bit the two seed in this one. Lakers, on the other hand, they struggled throughout, just 7 of 26 from beyond the arc. And a dud from Anthony Davis. Gonna need better from the Brow in game two. The Brow knows it. Take a listen. Here's Anthony Davis.
There's no way we win in a game, let alone a series, you know, with me playing the way I play. So, I mean, this is on me. I take full responsibility for sure. We'll be better game two.
Lakers have been here before. Remember, they lost game one in the first two rounds last season. Chris Broussard, can the Lakers trust AD enough to win the series after what you saw from him in game one?
First of all, was that a pajama shirt? I mean, he said he was wearing. My goodness, first things first. I mean, but no, they cannot trust AD to be consistently great this season. That's just not who he is. He's not the guy he was last year for whatever reason. I don't expect him to stay like this the rest of his career. I think he'll get back to that guy maybe next season. But for whatever reason this season, he is up and down. That's not who he is. But they can trust that he won't be as bad as he was yesterday. I can't overstate how abysmal Anthony Davis was. It's not just the 13 points on 5 of 16 shooting. It wasn't just the fact that he failed to grab even one offensive rebound. It wasn't just that his plus minus was negative 18, which was twice as bad as anyone else that played in the game. It was the fact that he yet let a young, talented DeAndre Ayton dominate the game. It was Ayton's first playoff game ever. He should have smacked Ayton around and let him know, look, this is another level, son. This is the playoffs. You're not ready for this. And this is going to be 5 or 7 to 7 games of you learning about postseason basketball at my tutelage. That's what he should have done. Instead, he let Ayton gain confidence by going 10 of 11 from the field for 21 points, by grabbing 8 offensive rebounds. That's more than Anthony Davis had total. And he had 16 rebounds overall. Mm. And now, for the rest of the series, AD's going to have his hands full because DeAndre Ayton's thinking, I'm here. I can play at this level and I can dominate in the postseason and play as well or better yesterday than I did even in the regular season. So that's the main problem with what AD did. Now, with LeBron coming back and being LeBron, yesterday, don't get down. Look, it was a game one feel out. Look at Portland last year. Look at Houston last year. The Lakers lost. The Lakers lost the first games in those series. And they had everybody yelling, sweet, the Lakers are going to be swept. The Lakers are going to be beat. So LeBron will get back to controlling the game. AD will be better. He's going to have a couple of great games. He's going to have a couple of solid games. And he might have one more bad game, but not as bad as yesterday. And that'll be enough for the Lakers to win the series. But I don't trust them to be consistently great this year.
What is wrong with you and Nick? What is wrong with you and Nick? Did you not watch the game? And it's been happening all year. Talking about, oh, it's the worst ever. No, it's been happening all year. I'll be quick here, Wout and Nick, because I've been saying the same thing all year. I don't want to be redundant. I keep saying it. AD is the problem. AD is not the same person in the bubble. We talked about this when he was still on the bench. Everybody's talking about the Lakers are going to be better when AD comes back. Well, he comes back and he's still the same guy. It's more of the same. So please, no, they shouldn't trust AD. AD is struggling. You never see great players have terrible years. You just don't see it. So it makes me believe something else is going on. If you watch the game and you watch his effort on the defensive side, like no help D, he doesn't seem there. You watch his emotions after he throws down a monster slam. He's no facial expressions, nothing there. It's like, what's going on with AD? So Nick, you guys should be concerned. And the real question is, do you still have the Lakers winning?
Of course. Yeah, listen, I thought they would lose game one. I didn't think they would look as bad as they did. And by the way, losing game one beforehand to me was expected. But once Chris Paul got hurt and was obviously a shell of himself, they should have taken advantage of it and they couldn't. Anthony Davis was terrible. Where I will give Anthony Davis the benefit of the doubt is he has played 35 career playoff games. This was his worst one. I do not think he's going to be this bad again. He has never played this poorly in the playoffs prior to yesterday afternoon. And it was everything Broussard said. And you said, Brandon, it was effort, it was activity, it was energy, it was all of the above. But Brandon, you said the LeBron game one feel out is made up. No, it's not. In his playoff career, he wins 58% of... Okay, well, Brandon, explain these numbers if you're so perplexed by it. He wins 58% of game one games. That is the lowest of any game in the series. He wins 74% of game two games. He has if you look at the rare times he has had bad playoff games, the last time he was this bad or ineffective was game one of the 2018 Eastern Conference Finals against Boston. He also played yesterday fewer minutes than he's played in a loss in the playoffs in 7 years, if you exclude a couple 30-point blowouts where he didn't play the fourth quarter. Like, it was pretty clear he was seeing what the defense was trying to do and will adjust for game two.
Yeah, the reason why I'm perplexed is because I've been hearing it for years and I just don't understand. You don't know who the Suns are? What are you filling out? What are you feeling now? You played them a couple times this year. What, three times this year? So I just don't understand it, why any player or any team will go into, you know, a playoff game, the first playoff game, and say, well, let me figure out what they're going to do on offense. Let me figure out what they're going to do on defense. It all matters. It's all important. So I just don't understand this whole narrative of this fill-out game. I don't understand it.
Well, listen, in your defense,
it's a seven-game series.
It is a strategy. But it's also a strategy that I can't point to a lot of players that have done it. One of the benefits, Wilds, of being the greatest player ever is you can not punt a game one, but you can use game one as an evaluation period to then tweak and adjust and figure out what you need the rest of the way. Because as bad as the Lakers were yesterday, they won the LeBron minutes. They were plus two in the 36 he played and minus 11 in the 12 he sat. So, and he will be more active and he will be more aggressive. And Anthony Davis, while I don't know that we're going, Brandon might be right, we might not get the bubble AD from last year, but he was terrible yesterday. The only guy who might have been worse was Drummond. He was awful yesterday, and the Lakers need to adjust accordingly. He needs to adjust accordingly.
So I don't think Anthony Davis all of a sudden became bad at basketball. He looks like a guy who's not necessarily injured, but he certainly looks like a guy who's hurt, right, Broussard? He's hanging around the three-point line like he's, you know, J.J. Redick. He's out there setting picks, and the offense is not really rolling through him. And when he does get the ball, he's sort of like trying to do a little bit too much and not just going down to the post, making a spin move, and dunking the ball. So to me, he looks like a guy who's hurt. Here's the other thing. I'm putting LeBron officially on the Blake Griffin. When's the last time you dunked watch meter? Didn't have a dunk yesterday. Didn't have a dunk against the Warriors. So for me, LeBron is also playing a little bit passively. I'm not sure that he's 100%. He said himself he's not 100%. But I think both of these guys' health, they're both a little bit more hurt than we public thinks they are.
It's over, guys. It's over,
guys. All right, they're back at it tomorrow night.
It's okay.
Game two, 10 Eastern. All right, Brandon, you're up next. We'll talk about your Brooklyn Nets. The big three got loose in game three. Chris. Did they prove why they are title favorites? It's next. First things first. Stick around.
Oh, yes, they did.
Brandon just declared the Lakers. Yeah.